गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन चिल्ड्रन टुडे लेट्स कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 4 ऑफ योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज नाउंस एंड इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट काइंड्स ऑफ नाउन. चिल्ड्रन यू नो अ नाउन इज अ नेमिंग वर्ड. द मोस्ट टिपिकल नाउंस आर नेम्स ऑफ पर्सन्स प्लेसेस और things such as John, Shimla, book, pen, Agra, etc. So children, let's know about kinds of noun. Children, you know there are four main kinds of noun. First is proper noun, second is common noun, third is collective nouns, and the fourth one is abstract nouns. First of all, let's know about proper nouns. Children, a proper noun is the name of a particular person or place or a thing. Besides, the name of mountains, rivers, seas and oceans are usually considered as proper nouns. A proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Children, proper noun क्या होता है? Proper noun is always a particular person or place or thing, like Peter, Mary, Sohan, Mohan, Aslam, Ravi, etc. And the places like Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Bisoli, Badayun, etc. You know, and the mountains, the Himalayas, the Alps, the Rockies, the Atlas, the Everest, and the rivers, for example, the Satluj, the Ganga, the Kaveri, the Krishna, the Yamuna, and the seas and oceans, for example, Pacific Ocean, Bay of Bengal, the Red Sea, the Indian Ocean, and the Arabian Sea. These are the examples of proper noun. Children, when an animal is given a particular name, it is a proper noun. For example, when you give a name to your pet dog and you are calling your pet dog as the name Jack, means Jack is a proper noun. Okay, children, now let's know about common noun. A common noun is the name given in common to every person or thing or animal of the same kind or class. For example, Akbar was a great king. Now in this sentence, king, there is a word king, and the king word is an example of common noun, because here king represent the all kings of the world, not only Akbar. Akbar is a proper noun, but here the king word is a common noun, because when you say only king, then the king word represents all the king of the world, okay, not a particular king. King means all the king, okay. But when you are saying Akbar, that means Akbar was only proper a person, that's why Akbar is a proper noun, but king is a common noun. And in the second sentence, Anil is a boy. When you say boy, boy means boy is a category, and boy is a class, means the boy word represent all the class, all the boy, means the boys, boy is a class, and the boy word represent all the boys. That's why the boy word is a common noun, but Anil is a proper noun. Okay, next, London is a big city. Here the word city is a common noun, but London is a proper noun. Okay, children, in the above sentences, the word king, boy, city are general terms for all kings, boys and cities respectively, so they are common noun. Children, you know common nouns are divided into two kinds, countable and uncountable nouns. The noun that we can count are called countable nouns. For example, table. You can count tables. 1, 2, 3. How many tables are there in your house? You can count. Chair. You can count your chairs. How many chairs do you have in your classroom? You can count. 1, 2, 3, 30, 40, 50 chairs you have in your class. That means you can count the chairs. That's why chair is a countable noun. Book. How many books do you have in your bag? You can count. I have, yes sir, I have 5 books in my bag. That's why book is a countable noun. Pen. How many pens do you have in your box? You can count. I have 2 pens. That's why pen is a countable noun. Men. How many men are there in your house? You can count. Boy and girl. These are the countable nouns. And the nouns that we cannot count. जिन नाउंस को हम काउंट नहीं कर सकते, गिन नहीं सकते, उन्हें क्या कहते हैं? अनकाउंटेबल नाउंस कहा जाता है. ओके, फॉर एग्जांपल, फ्लोर, आइस, राइस, वाटर, ऑयल, व्हीट, एयर, सुगर, सैंड. चलन, कैन यू काउंट फ्लोर? नो ना, आप फ्लोर को यानी कि आटा को काउंट नहीं कर सकते, है ना. ऐसे आइस, आइस को काउंट नहीं किया जा सकता, राइस को काउंट नहीं किया जा सकता, वाटर को काउंट नहीं किया जा सकता, है ना. गिनती नहीं गिन सकते हम, कितना वाटर, 1, 2, 3 नहीं कर सकते. काउंट करेंगे तो हमें यूज़ करने के लिए किसी चीज़ की ज़रूरत होगी. मेजरमेंट करेंगे वाटर का, लीटर, कितना लीटर, कितना वाटर, तो वो काउंट नहीं कर सकते हम इसको, इसीलिए ये अनकाउंटेबल नाउन. ऑयल हो गया, व्हीट हो गया, एयर हो गया, सुगर हो गया, ये सब क्या हैं? अनकाउंटेबल नाउन्स. Now let's know about collective nouns. Children, a collective noun is the name of a group. First of all, you remember a group. When you are talking about a group of something, someone, then the word will be collective noun. Okay? A collective noun is the name of a group of persons or things taken together and spoken as one whole. Means, jab hum yahan pe किसी ग्रुप की बात करें, है ना, कई सारी चीज़ों को मिला के ग्रुप बनाते हैं, उस ग्रुप को हम पार्टिकुलर नेम दे देते हैं, तो वो नेम जो होगा वो क्या होगा? कलेक्टिव नाउन. फॉर एग्जांपल, द क्लास इज राइटिंग अ टेस्ट. मींस क्लास की जब हम बात कर रहे हैं तो क्लास क्या है? व्हाट इज अ क्लास? क्लास इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो, दैट्स वाई क्लास इज अ कलेक्टिव नाउन, बिकॉज क्लास is a group of students, group of students. Okay, so class word is a collective noun. Here class means all the pupils of the class. For example, family, nation, jury, parliament, committee are some of the collective nouns. For further information, you can read here a list of collective nouns: a bunch of grapes, a herd of cattle, a flock of sheep, a group of islands, a bundle of sticks, and many more are there. So you read all these examples. Now let's know about abstract nouns. Children, an abstract noun is the name of a quality, feeling, action, or state. So children, for example, you can see here quality. What kind of quality? Means patience, honesty, wisdom, courage, brightness. The things that you cannot touch, जिनको आप touch नहीं कर सकते, ऐसी सारी चीज़ें किस में आती हैं? Abstract noun में आती हैं. For example, feelings. For example, qualities, actions, state. You know, feelings, surprise. Can you touch a surprise? No, no. आप surprise को touch नहीं कर सकते. That's why surprise word is a abstract noun, is an abstract noun. Fear, आपने fear देखा है कभी, touch किया है? नहीं ना, इसी वजह से ये जो fear word होगा वो क्या होगा? Abstract noun. Joy, sorrow, ecstasy, hatred, growth, obedience, motion, arrival. State, states, boyhood, prosperity, slavery, manhood, and mastery. These words are abstract nouns. The names of arts and sciences are also abstract nouns. For example, poetry, music, painting, literature, and drawing. These all words are abstract noun. The names of subject of study are also abstract nouns. For example, history, science, Hindi, English. These all are abstract nouns. And some abstract nouns can be used as countable nouns. For example, departure, pilgrimage, thefts, and agreements. These words are also abstract nouns.